Okay, so let's face it. If you're trying to slim down for the summer, you're probably going to have to ditch some of your favorite comfort foods. I'm sorry to break the news to you.
I don't want to hear that.
I know, I'm sorry.
What a downer.
I know, Debbie Downer.
All right, but don't lose hope. Here to show us five slimming substitutions for classic summer treats is Dr. Oz's alternative health guru, holistic nutritionist Peggy Katsopoulos.
Hey, welcome.
Good, thank you.
Well, that's a lofty title.
Right. What is an alternative health guru?
So I'm a holistic nutritionist. So basically, okay. We take
What's
a natural,
that?
Whole food approach to feeling your best every day.
Really? Okay, so when you say
very,
whole
very
foods,
natural
those are not
ingredients.
Like processed
Nothing
things?
Processed. Everything's okay. Whole foods. We're not using any refined foods at all. And very, very simple ingredients.
Really?
So, and they're all functional foods. They have a certain benefit to help you feel great.
Now, when you speak like that, you make me think very expensive way to eat.
No.
Is that not the case?
I'm going to show you some stuff that it's so simple. It's actually very, very clean ingredients and just very few stuff. So, like things like bananas and avocados and berries and watermelon, things that you can get seasonally right now from any grocery store.
I like okay. it. But before we get to that, let's talk Dr. Oz. How did you link up with him, and what's he like to work with?
Amazing. He's so awesome. Yeah, he's so, the way you see him on TV is the way he is in real life. He's just, he makes everyone feel really calm, and he's very smart, and he's such a cool guy.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Really
cool
and you
guy.
Give some of these same tips on his show, and today you're going to talk about replacing some of your favorite foods with five foods and five things that we can still be satisfied eating, right?
Exactly.
Okay. Well, that's the thing, because during the summer months, you want cocktails, you want ice cream, burgers, potato salad, all of those things, and you're saying that we cannot have those things but still have a great summer.
Exactly.
Are you promise?
I promise.
Okay.
I promise.
Are there other staples we should definitely avoid, like bread? Because you're
I know.
Bread. Right?
I mean, in moderation, right?
Okay.
So that's going to cause, bread is going to cause belly fat. So if you're trying to thin down your tummy over the summer, you want to kind of, eliminate sugar. So basically that falls into the sugar category.
All right,
so
let's
I'm going to talk
it.
You through
yes.
some fun stuff.
Yeah.
So ice cream is something, it's hot outside,
nice.
We want our ice cream. Yep. So this one that we made right here, if you want to try it, I'll give you some spoons.
Okay.
Wait, I'm not allowed to eat ice cream and desserts.
Okay, so here what you can do here, it's very simple. What's inside is frozen bananas.
Wait a minute, so it's not ice cream?
It's not even ice cream. It has the consistency of ice cream, but it's basically vanilla bean. We take some vanilla bean. Throw the frozen, you take your bananas really ripe, peel them, throw them in the freezer.
Okay.
Throw them in the blender with some vanilla bean and some cinnamon, blend it up, and or in the food processor, and you throw it in the freezer, and you can scoop it out, and you have ice cream. And what we're doing for our chocolate drizzle is something called Yakon syrup.
Oh, wait, I want to taste it before you put the chocolate drizzle on, because I don't like chocolate, but let me taste
try this.
Okay.
But you have the creamy consistency, try that. Let me know what you think.
Wow. It doesn't seem like bananas at all. It seems like real ice cream. Are you sure?
Like ice cream. I promise.
Okay.
I promise. It's just bananas. But what you can have here is we have some, you can use some maple syrup and some cocoa powder. That's it. We just mix two ingredients.
Okay.
And you can drizzle it right on top.
Nice.
And you have like your chocolate syrup, just like that.
And this will be a great way to fool the kids into eating healthy and think they're eating ice cream.
So again, these are things you can get from your grocery store. You can top it up with some walnuts, which are healthy omega-3 fatty acids.
Mm-hmm.
And you've got a great dish. Did you want to try that too?
On average, how many calories is something like this versus ice cream? Because I know a scoop of ice cream can be anywhere from 200 to 400 calories, depending on
so
how rich it is.
So one scoop of this is only around 80 calories.
Oh, nice.
Yes.
Oh, that's
great. And there's no saturated fats. There's no dairy in there. It's allergen-free, dairy-free. There's no sugar. We added no additional sugar except for the banana.
And I don't even like banana, but this is good.
All right.
And we added some vanilla in there, too, for some flavor. So all the recipes you can get online and also from my book, Kitchen Cures, which we took all the recipes from.
Okay, now I see strawberries and a chocolate drink.
Yeah, so
that's not a milkshake.
This is not a milkshake. This is a frappuccino.
Ooh.
So if you go to your favorite coffee places and you get your summery treats and you want your frappuccino, this is a healthier alternative. So what we use actually is this Vega all-in-one nutritional shake.
Oh, yes.
And what it has is it has your vitamins, minerals, it has plant-based protein, it has all your greens in there. So it has like 10 different supplements in one. So it's kind of like your all-in-one health solution.
Now, Peggy, I know that a real frappuccino can be anywhere from 650 to 800 calories. How much is this on average?
So this on average is around 200 calories.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
So around 200. So basically, it's just a scoop of this. We use some unsweetened vanilla almond milk in there, or you can use unsweetened coconut milk, a shot of espresso, a little bit of almond butter to make it nice and rich.
And I like that it doesn't taste
refreshing.
And it doesn't taste powdery like some of the protein shakes
do. Yeah, no. It's just it tastes really thick and really rich. So instead instead of your Frappuccino, and there's hardly any sugar in here. There's only around 16 grams of sugar. Most Frappuccinos have around 60, mm-hmm. 60 wow. to 100 yeah. grams of sugar. It's all sugar. Yeah. It's all sugar, so very, very low sugar, and really good for you, too. Really all good right. for your body.
Now, this looks healthy.
Yes,
this
so,
looks healthy.
So we know what that is.
We know what that is.
So a lot of times you go to barbecues and stuff in summers, and people bring salads because it's a healthier, right. and also it's nice and fresh and light. Mm-hmm. And pasta salad is a big thing.
Right.
So instead
but
of your
pasta
typical,
salad has all that mayonnaise and things
has all
of that
the mayonnaise.
Nature.
It has, I mean, the carbs, again, going right. back to simple sugars. So what we have here is something called, we're using kelp noodles.
Kelp noodles?
Yes, so these noodles here are made out of kelp, which is a sea vegetable.
Right.
And one cup of this is only 12 calories.
No.
12?
12 calories per cup. Wow. Super low calories, hardly any carbs, actually no carbs at all. And it's really, you basically get it in a package from any health food store. You just rinse them and you want to marinate them really well. We made our own dressing, again, which you can get online, which has, we have some extra virgin olive oil. Okay. We blended some macadamia nuts in there to give it the creaminess. And then we added, you know, some cabbage, some cilantro. You know, we made this really, really yummy, creamy kelp noodle salad.
What are the little red things?
So these are goji berries.
Goji berries.
Oh, yes. Like superfood,
so
right?
Yeah, these are great. You can just sprinkle them right on top. What we did is we rehydrated them because they're a dry, kind of crunchy type of fruit. And a really high in beta carotene, so good for your skin when you're in the sun as well, just to protect your skin from sun damage.
Yeah.
Really, really good.
Yeah,
so like gives it a nice shot at color.
The goji berry is a superfood. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Very good for you, right?
And then you got the noodles. So these are kind of, but what you want to do is you want to marinate them and you want to dress them up because they really have no taste to them.
All right.
What do you think about them?
I see a martini glass here.
Okay, now you're talking.
Yes, now we're talking. So mojitos.
Go, Peggy. Go, Peggy.
We love our mojitos.
Okay.
So what we have here is we have a watermelon mojito.
Okay.
So watermelon is really hydrating, great for the summer. It's a seasonal fruit. And what we're adding to it, so we have some watermelon blended here with some lime juice and some lemon juice.
Okay.
So if you want to just pour that into the shaker cup.
I'll do that.
And then we have some mint that we're going to add. And to get the mint, because you know, what's a mojito without mint? If you actually just like give it a little clap, it breaks it up. So instead of muddling the mint, you can just smack it.
Yeah, we had a mixologist on who told us to smack it.
Yeah,
smack the mint.
And then actually one thing we're adding to there as well is this is the Vega Sport. It's a hydrator. So it basically has your electrolytes, so it helps with hydration.
Oh.
So all it is calcium, magnesium, potassium. So when you're outside sweating in the heat, and you want something refreshing, this actually helps to hydrate you and really keep you hydrated.
Is that what all electrolytes do?
That's what they do. Oh, they help to hydrate. It increases hydration, improves hydration.
Okay, and so there's no alcohol
there's
in this.
There's no alcohol. You can add vodka. You can.
You can add
totally
vodka.
Vodka.
You have to
we don't
shake
have it here.
As well?
Shake it up, shake it up, shake it up.
Okay.
And you can just fill it up halfway through.
All right. Now the good thing about watermelon is it's water-based, so it pretty much
it's 90% water. Yeah, so halfway. And then what we're gonna do is just fill that up. And then you just top it up with some sparkly water just to give it a little fizziness, a little fizz.
Okay. A little party in a glass.
Exactly. But like vodka is great in this drink.
And
or you can use a rum,
this.
A white rum.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Or gin.
Yeah,
any of the above.
And alcohol dehydrates you, so you can hydrate.
That's what I'm saying.
Are there some alcohols that are better than other if you're only going to pick one alcohol?
I always say just like something really clean, like a vodka or a gin, because they're the lowest calorie.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Right?
That's
and this
delicious.
Is a very low calorie mixer that you're mixing it with. So think about this with that.
Cheers.
With no alcohol? Are you sure?
Wait a minute.
Like I said,
was this really
you
water?
Can add it. You can add.
That's delicious, though.
So it's very good. And then finally, moving on.
I see popsicles.
Yeah, popsicles.
Yay!
Wait, I thought I wanted to do an ice cream.
And there's no ice cream here again. So these are fudge pops. And I mean, I'll just pull it up to show you and you can try them. Just to have a look at how simple. Ooh, they're melted a little bit.
Uh-oh.
They're gonna break. They're melted. They've been sitting for a while.
Okay.
Anyways, they're really, really good. They're great popsicles. But what we actually made them with was as avocado. So instead of the ice cream and the cream, the heavy cream, we actually blended avocado with cocoa powder and some coconut milk, some unsweetened coconut milk, low calorie.
I'll put it in this
and
dish
some,
here for
you. You can try that. Yeah, you have to try because it's so good.
Okay.
All right.
And some coconut sugar. So we sweetened it with coconut sugar, which is a low glycemic sweetener.
Coconut
so it doesn't.
Sugar.
Yeah, so we have some in a little bowl there if you want to try it. It tastes almost like the top of a creme brulee. You know that burnt caramel taste?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, so it's very low glycemic, so it doesn't cause spikes and dips in your blood sugar level. So substitute any type of regular sugar for that, and it's so good for you.
Okay.
Way better for you.
That's delicious.
That was delicious.
But the avocado gives it the nice creaminess without any extra, you know.
I like that. Mm-hmm. Now, Peggy, let's talk about your new show.
Yeah.
Umbria. Yes. What is it? And is it really all about this, healthy alternatives?
Yes. Mm-hmm. So what it is it's Peggy Kay's Kitchen Cures on Umbria Living Network.
Oh,
and
nice.
What it does is every episode is on a different ailment. So same with my book. Every chapter is on a different ailment. So whether you're stressed out, whether you have, you know, pain and inflammation, whether you want to improve the look of your skin, mm-hmm. shrink your muffin top, go to that chapter, whatever it is, get rid of those thunox, uh-huh. go to that chapter, and it tells you the specific, and it tells you key nutrients and the top foods that'll help you get out of your funk and amazing recipes that will help
okay,
any kind of food solution.
What's one must-know kitchen cure yes. right now?
One must-know kitchen cure mm-hmm. right now? Oh, there's somebody. Pick a topic and I'll tell you one.
I don't know if we...
Oh, have a...
Yeah, okay. skin, because it's all about skin.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
extra virgin olive oil, the best thing. It actually helps to prevent free radical damage from the sun and prevent wrinkles. So it actually, not only applying it topically, but also eating it will help protect your skin from sun damage. For shiny hair in the sun, in the summertime, mm-hmm. if you want lustrous locks, rinsing your hair with vinegar.
Really?
Yes, it cuts
what about
through the
smell?
No, you rinse it out, and mm-hmm. then you can, you know, do it, whatever you want to it. Using an apple cider vinegar is a little bit better, but it actually cuts through all of the debris and will make your hair so shiny.
That is great. Now you're gonna have Dr. Oz on your show.
Yes, I should. I definitely should.
Well, Peggy, awesome. Peggy, thank you so much for being here.
Yes.
Thanks
for all of these
me.
Treats. Thank you.
For having me.
Cheers. I want that other shake.
Yeah. All right. Thank you.
Cheers. All right. And when can we watch the show?
Yeah. It is Tuesdays and Wednesdays at 8 p.m. on Free Living Network.
You got it. Thank you so much for joining us.
We're there, and you're here, Arise Entertainment 360.